day. Timmy's all asleep?
Haven't heard him. You better give me mine.
Well, I thought we'd all have breakfast together.
I have to go downtown.
Today?
Yeah. Downtown on business. Thought I'd stop off at St. Francis on the way. All for a prayer of thanks.
Toast?
Yes. All those casualties, and he never got a scratch. We're very lucky.
Anything on it?
Marmalade. Freeman boy dead, Mullen boy crippled for life. Makes you wonder. Think he enjoyed the party?
He seemed to.
First time I ever saw him take a drink.
He drank too much.
You don't get out of the army every day.
He was sick during the night.
Probably the excitement.
It was the whiskey, and you should have stopped him.
He got along fine for 3 years without anyone telling him what to do.
I had to hold his head.
No one held his head in the army.
That's what he said.
That didn't stop you.
Well, he's not in the army anymore.
3 years ago, it was a boy that walked out of this house. It was a man who walked back in.
You sound like a recruiting poster.
You sound ready to repeat the old mistakes.
Mistakes?
Pardon me.
You said mistakes.
Slip of the tongue.
I'd like to know what mistakes you're referring to.
Coffee's excellent.
I'd really like to know.
Up until the age of 18, he showed no special skill at anything. You insisted on treating him like he was some sort of protege.
I think you mean prodigy.
What I really mean is a baby.
Well, for a baby, he certainly did well in the army.
I didn't say he was a baby, I said you treated him like one.
You were surprised he did well. You didn't think he'd last a week.
Bless us and save us, says Mrs. O'Davis.
Do you know why you're surprised?
Joy, joy, said Mrs. Malloy.
Because you never understood him.
Mercy, mercy, said old Mrs. Percy.
I never doubted he would do as well as anyone else.
Yeah, when he's concerned, you never doubted, period. If he walked in right now and said he could fly, you'd help him out the window.
You're saying I have confidence in him, you're right. And why not? Who knows him better?
Is there any more coffee?
He's exceptional.
Here we go again.
Yes, exceptional.
In what way?
I refuse to discuss it.
Someone who's going to be famous usually drops a few clues by the time they're 21.
I didn't say famous, I said exceptional.
What's the difference?
You wouldn't understand.
Well, here's something you better understand. You can't treat him like he's never gone away. He's not a kid anymore.
If you had stopped him from drinking so much, would that have been treating him like a kid?
This is where I come in.
He was trying to keep up with you, and you knew it.
You sound jealous.
The two of you, so busy drinking, you hardly paid attention to anyone else.
You are jealous.
Don't be absurd.
He and I got along better yesterday than we ever did before. And you're jealous. Well, well, well.
Can't Ruskin wait till Monday?
No. And don't pretend you're disappointed. What a charming little breakfast you and he will have together.
You're welcome to stay.
My ears are burning already.
I have never said a word against you, and you know it.
Don't forget my little excursion to Montreal.
It was always your own actions that turned him against you.
And a convention. Don't leave that out.
Curtains. Curtains for Timmy's room. They're coming today.
I don't know anything about any curtains.
Yes, you do.
I do not.
They'll be $10.
What's the matter with the old ones?
They're worn out.
They look all right to me.
They are all right.
$10 for curtains?
Timmy will want to bring friends home.
Oh, the old squeeze play.
Are you going to give me the money?
Here.
I need $5 for the house.
I gave you 15 yesterday.
That was the fun.
What? The party cost close to $100.
It was worth it.
Did I say it wasn't? There.
Oh, I smelled the coffee.
Your mother says you were sick during the night.
Well, I'm all right now.
I was a little rocky myself.
Yeah, I wonder why.
What time is your appointment?
11:15.
25, huh?
Mr. Ruskin wants to see me downtown.
Oh, that's too bad.
Why?
I thought we might take in the Giants game.
Why don't you?
You know I can't. This thing with Ruskin means a sure sale.
Yeah, I understand.
We'll go tomorrow.
My mother expects us for dinner tomorrow.
How about Nick Saturday?
Yeah,
we'll
right.
Get box seats, the works.
Yeah, that sounds great.
Swell.
What time will you be home?
I'll call you later.
I'll be at my mother's.
Say, I understand none of your old clothes fit. Oh,
that's right.
Well, why don't you meet me downtown on Monday? I'll get you some new ones.
All right.
Watch out. I still think I could take you.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised.
Say, what did you say you got this one for?
Oh, it's a combat infantry badge.
How about that?
It's not as important as it sounds.
We ought to sit down and have a real talk. I want to hear all about it.
All right.
It's great having you back home.
It's great to be back home.
The Mullen boy crippled, the Freeman boy dead. We're very lucky.
I know.
I'm stopping off at St. Francis on the way to offer a prayer of thanks.
Right.
I'll see you later.
Right.
How did you sleep?
Fine. How's he doing?
All right.
He looks a lot older.
It's been 3 years. It must have seemed strange, sleeping in your old bed.
How's his business?
Who knows?
The coffee market's off.
I hope you're hungry.
God, I can't get over the change in him.
Guess what we're having for breakfast.
Yeah, it's not just the way he looks.
Guess what we're having for breakfast. Guess what we're having.
What?
Guess.
I don't know.
Yes, you do.
No.
Sure you do.
What is it?
You're fooling.
What is it?
What's your favorite?
Bacon and eggs.
Oh, now I know you're fooling.
No.
I forgot what a tease you were.
I'm not teasing.
Waffles. We're having waffles.
Fine.
You used to be crazy about waffles.
I still am.
I had the waffle batter ready.
As well.
And you are entitled to have whatever you want.
I want waffles.
Oh, I used the last egg in the batter.
I want waffles. I want waffles.
Really?
Cross my heart.
All right.
I see there's a new butcher.
Oh, quite a few new stores.
Pop said the Bremen's moved.
And the Costello's? Oh. Remember old Zimmer the tailor?
Sure.
A few weeks ago, a woman brought him a coat she wanted altered. Zimmer started to fix it, then very politely excused himself, went up to the roof and jumped. No one knows why.
Who was the woman?
Mrs. Levin.
That explains it.
That's not funny.
God, I'm sorry.
What a thing to say.
What? I said I'm sorry. It's funny.
I'm surprised at you.
Oh, bless us and save us.
What?
Bless us and save us. As in bless us and save us, said Mrs. O'Davis, Joy Joyce, and Mrs. Malloy. What's the matter?
I never expected to hear that nonsense from you.
Well, beat swearing.
It used to cover your ears when your father said that.
Well, I'll never say it again.
Don't talk to me like that. Oh. I'm sorry. I don't know what got into me. I don't think I slept well. The party and all, too much excitement. Will you have bacon with it?
Just the waffles will be fine.
I hope you like the party.
Yes?
I'm sorry the house didn't look better.
What's wrong with
it? Oh, it needs painting, and the sofa's on its last legs, and the rugs. Well, now that you're here, I'll get it all fixed up.
It looks fine to me.
I still can't believe you're here.
Finding it hard to believe it myself.
You are here.
You want to pinch me? Go ahead. You believe it now? Pinch to a customer. It's a house rule. The waffles are done. The little light went out. Isn't that what it means when the light goes out? What's the matter? What's wrong? What is it?
They're stuck.
What?
Why did they have to stick today?
The waffles?
I can't remember the last time they stuck.
What's that to cry about?
I have been looking forward to this breakfast for 3 years. And nothing is right.
Well, what's not right?
Not one thing.
Well, what's wrong with this?
Not one single thing.
Oh, will you please stop?
The things you've been saying and your attitude.
What things? What attitude?
You haven't even asked about Willis.
Well, how is he?
And every time I look at you, you avoid me.
Oh, that's ridiculous.
You're doing it now.
I'm not.
How could you forget that waffles were your favorite?
I just forgot.
And you must have forgotten a lot of things.
Tell you one thing I didn't forget. The dance? The dance we were supposed to have the first morning I got back?
What made you think of that?
Well, I was thinking about it all morning.
I'll bet.
Well, I was about to turn on the radio when you started crying.
I'll bet.
Well, I'll do it now if you're through. Are you through?
Well, I haven't danced in so long that I've probably forgotten how.
Well, what do you say?
I can't remember the last time I did.
Shall we have a go at it?
You really want to?
Yes.
You asked for it.
Oh. Yes.
Whoa!
There you go. Atta girl. Forgot how to dance. Who are you kidding?
Well, I guess it's one of those things you never forget.
Yeah. Whoa! Oh, remember this? Come here often?
First time!
Be likewise, by yourself?
With our friend!
What did you forget?
Nothing.
Then why did you come back?
Changed my mind. You still want to go to that ball game? It's a date.
What about Ruskin?
The hell with Ruskin. You still want to go?
Yeah, sure.
What about Willis?
What about Willis?
Timmy was going to see him this afternoon.
Well, we'll see him tomorrow.
But I told him he'd be over today.
Before you even asked me?
Well, I felt sure you'd want to.
You had no right to do that.
What will I tell him?
Tell him I'll see him tomorrow.
He'll be disappointed.
That's not my fault.
Hey, the game starts at 12 o'clock.
Let me go grab my tie.
You haven't eaten.
We'll grab something on the way.
You know, I came out of St. Francis and I started heading for the subway. Got about halfway there when I thought of Mr. Freeman. What wouldn't he give to spend the day with his son? Made me turn around and come back. What are you mad for? You told me to take him to the game.
And you always do what I tell you?
Oh, bless us and save us.
Corporal Cleary, reporting for duty, sir.
Kiss your mother goodbye.
That's not a duty. So long, Mom.
We won't be late.
Come on, hurry up. Get the jacket. Come on. Let's go, let's go, let's go, let's go.
And he says, the difference is he's a skinny little runt. I haven't told that one in years.
You know, I was considered a very funny fellow thanks to you.
Hello? Anybody home? Still out of mothers.
Hey, let me get these in water.
Stand another beer?
Yeah, sure.
Thought he lost it in the sun. He's going back. He's going. Whoa! So they really went for the old man's jokes,
yeah,
huh?
Especially the ones about Uncle Mike.
Oh, such as?
The Pennsylvania Hotel gag.
Oh, Columbus. Columbus told that one to the Indians.
You know, Uncle Mike was considered a very funny fellow in our outfit.
All joking aside, he was quite a guy. He stood 6'3". Weighed close to 250 pounds.
I remember his picture.
He was in the Spanish-American War.
I know.
He got knocked flat by a bullet once. When he comes to, he's lying in a field full of wounded soldiers. All the ones who were sure goners, they had marked with a yellow tag, so no one would waste any time on them. All the others had blue tags. Mike looks down at his wrist, sees a yellow tag. Looks across at the fellow next to him, who's unconscious, notices he's got a blue one. Quick as a wink, Mike... He leans over, switches the two tags. Medics come by, Mike stands up. Look at this. I'm telling you war stories. Go on, you do the talking.
About what?
You must have seen some pretty bad things.
Not as much as a lot of the others.
Maybe you don't want to talk about it.
No, I don't mind.
I'd really like to hear what you have to say.
I don't know where to begin.
First thing that comes to your mind.
You want to know the bravest thing I ever did?
Yes.
First night we were in combat, I slept with my boots off.
Go on.
That's it.
You slept with your boots off?
Yeah, it doesn't sound like much, does it?
Not offhand.
Well, you see, all the guys who eventually cracked up were all guys who couldn't sleep. See, if I didn't decide to take off my boots, I would have ended up being one of them.
Oh, I see.
You know the smartest thing I ever did?
Sure.
I never volunteered. Lieutenant bawled me out for it one day. I said, sir, if there's something you want me to do, tell me and I'll do it. But if you wait for me to volunteer, you'll wait forever.
What'd he say to that?
Nothing printable. Fact is, I wasn't a very good soldier, Pop.
Oh, you did everything they asked.
The good ones do more. You would have been a good soldier.
What makes you say that?
I can tell.
Well, thanks.
You're welcome.
It was the biggest regret of my life, never being in the service.
I know.
When World War I was declared, I went right down to the recruiting office. When they found out I was the sole support of the family, they turned me down flat.
I know.
Lots of fellas made cracks. Especially guys like Clayton and Harper, who waited to be drafted, and then wangled safe jobs at Governor's Island and the Navy Yard. I fixed air wagons. One night, set the Army flying one way and the Navy the other. And that was the last from slacking I ever heard from them. Still, I regret missing out on the whole thing, though. I often wonder what difference it would have made in my life. And then I wonder how I would have turned out. But I wouldn't have settled for no desk job. I would have gone to the front.
I'm sure of that.
Once there, how would I have done?
Just fine.
How do you know?
You're a born fighter.
Well, they say lots of guys who were terrorists as civilians, they turned to jelly once they heard those bullets.
Not you.
Yeah, it doesn't seem so. But you can't be sure. That's always bothered. How about another one?
Sure.
We better not.
Why?
Your mother blames me for your being sick the other night. She says I encouraged you to drink too much.
Nah, it wasn't what I drank. It was the excitement.
That's what I told her.
I'll open two more.
Oh, her father used to send her roses every month. Actually, every birthday, every month. A dozen red ones. Never missed, even at the end.
Hey, why don't we tell her they were your idea?
What?
Yeah, tell her the roses came from you.
Why?
She'll get a kick out of it, all right?
I feel like.
Hey, you call it this time.
To the two nicest fellas in the house.
I'll drink to that. Boy, it's funny how you acquire a taste for things.
Yes.
You know, when I was a kid, I couldn't even stand the smell of beer.
Believe it or not, I was the same.
Yeah, well, we seem to have gotten over it.
Yeah. Can I say something to you?
Sure.
You won't take it the wrong way?
No.
I owe you an apology.
For what?
You were always sick. Staying home from school for one thing or another. I never thought you'd last in the Army.
Neither did I.
Really?
Really.
When Dr. Goldman heard they took you, he said it was ridiculous. When he found out they put you in the infantry, he said it was inhuman.
And when I survived?
He said it was a miracle. I don't think it was a miracle. I think we both underestimated you. At least I did. That's what I want to apologize for.
Remember that corny thing you used to recite? About how a boy thinks his father is the greatest guy in the world until he's 15? And the doubt starts. By the time he turns 18, he's convinced that his father is the worst guy in the world. And when he turns 25, the doubts start again. When he reaches 30, to realize that his old man wasn't so bad after all. And then at 40...
What about it?
There's some truth to it.
I think you've had too much to drink.
I'm not saying you were a saint.
That's a relief.
I'm just saying that everything you've been through, the obstacles you've had to overcome, what you've done is something to be proud of.
Thank you.
I mean, how many guys did you grow up with even turned out legitimate?
Not many.
Yeah, most of them are still scraping along where they started.
That's true.
How many years of school did you have?
I had to drop out at the end of the fourth grade.
You know, I've met college graduates who don't know half as much as you about the things that really matter.
They must be Yale men.
I'm serious.
Speaking of college, if you get into one of those big ones the GI Bill won't pay for, I'll help you out.
Thanks.
But that's just between you and me.
Why?
I don't want people getting notions.
About what?
That I'm loaded.
Well, are you loaded?
Don't be ridiculous.
Well, it doesn't answer my question.
Question's ridiculous.
Still no answer.
No, I'm not loaded.
Well, how much do you have?
What?
How much money do you have?
Is this your idea of a joke?
No.
Well, what are you doing it for?
I said I want to take your money if you can't afford it.
I can afford it.
Some of the places that I applied to are pretty expensive.
I can afford it.
Well, then you must be fairly loaded.
I am not loaded.
We have a car, a summer house, and now you tell me you can afford any school in the country. You must be fairly loaded.
If I hear that word one more time, I'm going to march right out the door.
You haven't changed a bit. Look at you. You look as if I asked you to betray your country.
You son of a gun.
I really had you going, didn't I?
Some joke.
Oh, say, Pop, how much money do you have?
Hey, enough's enough. I think we ought to change the subject.
All right. How did you meet Mother? When you said change the subject.
You know all about that.
What? You said you picked her up on the subway.
Oh, picked her up. Makes it sound so cheap.
Sorry.
The first time I ever spoke to her was on a subway, but there was more to it than that.
Tell me.
Why?
Because I might want to be a writer someday, and I might want to do a story about it.
A writer?
A writer.
Well, this is the first I heard about this.
Me too. Must be the beer. So what year was it that you met her?
1921. A writer?
A writer! Where were you working then?
At Emerson's. Well, I looked out the window, saw her walk by. That afternoon, she passed again. Next day, the same thing. Are you sure you want to hear all this?
Uh-huh.
Well, one evening, I happened to leave work the same time as she did. Turns out, we both took the same subway. She got off at 72nd Street. To make a long story short, I sat down next to her one day, and we started to talk.
Sounds like an ordinary pickup to me.
Well, it wasn't. I left some things out.
Such as?
I forget. It was 25 years ago. Mm-hmm. Now.
That's funny, because the way I remember it, you followed her around for a month before you finally got the nerve to talk to her.
Hey, I thought you didn't know this story.
Yeah, to convince her that your intentions were honorable, you finally asked if you could call it her home. True or false? Well?
True.
Ah.
You wouldn't believe how nervous I was. She didn't make it any easier. She pretended the whole darn thing was a complete surprise. Bernhardt couldn't have done it any nicer. Or looked nicer. She was dressed all in blue. Blue dress, blue hat, blue shoes. Everything blue, light blue. And very dignified. One look at her and you knew she was a lady. My folks called her the lady. To their minds, it was an insult. Say, how do we get on this anyway?
Oh, you were just...
Hey, join the party.
Hey, we're having a little hair of the dog.
How was the game?
One-sided.
Hey, Pop was just telling me about how you and he met.
He asked me.
Yeah, his version is a little different than yours.
What do you mean?
He says that you chased him.
That would be the day.
He said you did everything but stand on your head to get his attention.
You too.
How about a beer?
No, thanks.
Oh, come on.
You sport.
All right.
Atta girl.
Just a glass. What did he tell you?
He said that you were dressed in blue and that no one ever looked nicer.
I'll bet.
Didn't you say that?
Hey, I'm a stranger here.
Did he tell you how he used his friend, Eddie Barnes?
Oh, bless us and save us.
Every night, they get on a subway, stand right in front of me, and have a loud thank you, and have a loud conversation about how well they're doing in business.
It wasn't every night.
Poor Eddie had to go an hour out of his way.
Wow, that's what I call a friend.
The best I ever had. Here you go, here's your beer.
come from?
Pop got them for you.
You did?
Yes.
Beautiful. Thank you.
You're welcome.
What made you do it?
Well, we happened to pass by a place, and I know you like
them. I haven't had a bed of roses since Papa died. He used to send me a dozen on my birthday. Never missed.
I remember.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
I'm gonna cry.
Oh, forget. You don't bring flowers, they cry. You do, they cry.
I'm sorry.
What's to be sorry about?
He was the kindest, gentlest man that ever lived.
I know.
I'm all right now.
Yeah, here's what you need.
Maybe so.
Here. To happy days?
Happy days.
They're just beautiful.
I was speaking of Eddie Barnes before. God rest his soul. Reminds me of the time old man Emerson put up a secondhand car to the guy who sold the most coffee in a 3-month period. I won, but I didn't know how to drive. Eddie said he'd teach me. We hadn't gotten 2 blocks from the office when, boom, he runs broadside into an ice truck.
How about that ride to Connecticut? He practically killed us all.
Oh, what was the name of that place we used to stay at?
The Rainbow Grove.
Big, fat, red-headed dame ran it.
Mrs. Hanlon.
Mrs. Hanlon. All my friends call me Daisy. I dubbed her the Will Rogers of Connecticut. She never met a man she didn't like.
Remember the night that you and Eddie and a couple of others picked her up, bed and all, and left her sleeping in the middle of the baseball field?
When we went out to play the next morning, she was still there.
What did you do?
We ruled that any ball hitting her on a fly was a ground rule double. We had a lot of fun at that place.
Yes.
I wonder if it's still there.
I wonder.
We ought to take a ride sometime and see.
All right.
Mm. Where are you going?
Well, I have to start supper.
Oh, forget it. Where are you eating out?
I bought a steak.
It'll keep. Where do you want to go, champ?
Maybe he has. A date?
Bring her along.
I don't have a date.
Well, I thought you'd be seeing that Davis girl.
Oh, that's finished.
But she was a nice girl.
She was a dunce.
Oh,
Pop's right.
You men are terrible.
You're too kind.
Hey, so where are we going?
I don't know. I'm gonna let you two decide. I gotta go see a man about a dog.
Hey, how about the Concourse Plaza?
All right.
I had a nice date today.
I'm glad.
He's quite a boy.
That's what I've been telling you for years.
We talked about that. We really talked, the way Eddie and I used to. The hell with the Concourse Plaza. We're going downtown. We're going to the New Yorker.
Ooh, you are in a good mood.
Why? Because I want to go downtown.
That? And the roses?
Are you going to talk about those roses all night?
Well, I just wanted to thank you for them.
You already have.
You sound as though you're sorry you got
Don't be ridiculous.
So what are you so angry about?
I'm just tired of hearing about them. A guy buys some roses, big deal.
You're embarrassed.
I am not.
You did something nice and you're embarrassed.
You don't know what you're talking about.
Don't worry, I won't tell you what.
Eddie, please.
All right, but I just want you to know how much I appreciate them.
Good, I'm glad.
I do, I really do. We haven't been to the New Yorker in years. I wonder if they still have that ice show. You suppose we'll have any trouble getting in on a Saturday night?
So, what did you two decide?
We're going to the New Yorker.
Well, digga, too.
And after that, we're going to the Diamond Horseshoe and then the Sawdust Trail.
Wow, really sounds like our night to howl.
That's what it is.
Oh! Come on, you call that a howl?
Thank you. behind the door.
Honestly.
Where would you be if you weren't here?
Here, I'll do it.
Have you ever seen such pretty hair?
Stop.
Beautiful hair.
You did that out the door.
Oh, home to wife and mother.
Someday we'll break our necks because you refuse to leave a light.
By the light.
By the light of the silvery moon.
That's just about enough.
Whatever you say, Antoinette.
I say to bed.
Oh, shank of the evening. Oh, oh, sir, there is nothing like a law degree. Springboard to anything.
So they say.
Anyone can be a lawyer. How many people become writers?
That's my point.
You should be proud of a son who wants to try something different.
Did I say I wasn't proud of him?
Abracadabra, cadidra, slatterer. Hey, the fellow in the red jacket that leads the horses to post in Jamaica always says that before the horses reach the starting gate. Abracadabra, cadidra, slatterer, and here are your horses for the first race. As long as you can say it, you're not drunk. Abracadabra, cadidra, slatterer.
Abracadabra.
Cadidra, slatterer.
Abracadabra, cadidra, slatterer.
Not cadabra, cadidra. Abracadabra, cadidra, slatterer.
Abracadabra, cadidra, slatterer.
Faster.
Abracadabra, cadidra,
faster.
Abracadabra, cadidra,
slatterer. Abracadabra, cadidra, slatterer. Ah, there's nothing wrong with us. That little nightcap won't kill.
I will not cap you.
Oh, I can't bear to hear married people fight.
We ought to go dancing more.
Now I know you're drunk.
Who was it that used to call us the Four Mortons?
Harold Bowling.
I wish we were.
Do you remember the first place I ever took you dancing?
Of course.
Bet you don't.
Of course I do. The crystal tent.
Magical feeling about vaudeville.
What was the first song we danced
to? Too late.
No matter how cheap and tinny the show is.
First song we ever danced.
As soon as the lights go down, the music starts. And we cry.
Pretty baby. A blonde guy crooned it.
Through a gold megaphone.
Remember.
Of course.
You've got snoo in your blood. What's new? I don't know. What's new with you?
What's he talking about?
Oh, he's playing the palace.
Take off the coat, my boy. Take off the coat. Take off the coat, my boy. The coat is off.
It's time for bed.
Okay, folks. So in closing, I would like to do a little dance made famous by the inimitable
pass, yes, my boy.
Maestro, if you please.
When
Irish
eyes are smiling.
I'm sorry, folks. No dance tonight. We're running a little bit late. So my father thanks you. My mother thanks you. My sister thanks you. And the Feltons thank you. So good night. Good night. Good night.
Good night.
Good night, Mrs. Cleary. Whoever you are.
Good night, dear.
Good night. Yeah. Rough house, but I think I warmed him up for
oh,
you.
Oh, thank you.
Hey, don't look now, but your leg's broken.
Ooh, but the show must go on.
Lucky lad. It's an honor sharing the bill with you.
Likewise. Mm-hmm.
So, good night, chap. Sleep well.
See you in the morning, champ.
Sure, you don't want an Alka-Seltzer?
Abracadabra, cadidra, slatterin. See you in the morning.
With the help of God.
Abracadabra, cadidra, slatterin, and here are your horses for the first race.
Home 2 days and both nights to bed like that.
Oh, he's entitled. You should have heard some of the things he's been through. Over in one of those concentration camps.
I don't want to hear about that now.
You're right. It's no way to end a happy.
I think we have some aspirin in the kitchen.
You didn't mention a headache before.
I don't have a headache.
What?
Well, I read somewhere that if you put aspirin in cut flowers, they keep longer. I wonder what made you get them.
I don't know.
Must have been some reason.
I just thought it'd be a nice thing to do.
It was.
I like your dress.
You've seen it before.
It's different tonight. Everything about you looks different.
What mass are you going to?
10:00.
I better set the alarm.
Nettie, I had a good time tonight.
So did I.
Did you really? Oh, you're putting it on for his sake.
I really did.
So did I.
I'll set the alarm.
Now that he's back, we'll have lots of good times.
What's wrong between you and I has nothing to do with him.
Oh, I didn't say it did.
We have to solve our own problems.
Of course.
And they can't be solved in one night.
I know.
One nice evening doesn't make everything different.
Did I say it did?
Oh, I guess you don't understand. I
forgot how nice you smell.
You'll spoil everything.
I want things to be right between us.
You think this will make things right?
We have to start someplace.
Start!
Oh, bless us and save us!
Shh! This is not my idea. Start!
Betty, I want you. I want you like I've never wanted anything before in my life.
You're drunk.
Please. Do you think I could ask again if I wasn't drunk?
I am not one of your hotel lobby whores.
If you were, I wouldn't have to ask again.
A couple of drinks and a couple of jokes. Let's jump into bed.
Maybe that's my mistake.
How do you suppose Ruskin managed without me today?
Really, you don't want to be asked.
Let me alone.
Come on, you've had the drinks. You had the jokes.
Stop.
What happened?
The roses. I knocked them over.
It sounded like a bomb.
I'm sorry I woke you. Oh, no, no. I'll clean up. You go back to bed, please.
Okay. Good night.
Good night.
Good night, Pop.
You moved me this afternoon. When you brought the roses, I felt something stir that I thought was dead forever. And now this, I don't understand.
I had nothing to do with the roses. They were his idea! Coffee's weak.
Add water.
I said weak. Waste of time bringing good coffee into this house. Thinking of renting the lake house. Business is off. What do you say?
About what?
Renting the lake house.
Timmy will be disappointed.
What about you?
I'm in favor of it.
Of course you are.
I wonder why.
Morning.
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 Nice of you to join us.
My pleasure.
This isn't a hotel. We take our meals at certain times.
You should have woke me.
Sorry.
Of course it is.
Sit down. What would you like?
Just some coffee.
Just coffee?
My stomach's a little bit shaky.
I wonder why.
I'll be all right.
2 days, two hangovers. Is that what they taught you in the army?
Cream, please. Thank you.
Thinking of renting the lake house.
How come?
I can use the money.
Oh.
Is that all you're going to say?
What do you expect me to say?
I thought that house meant something to you.
Well, it does.
A bunch of strangers sleeping in our beds, using our things. That doesn't bother you at all.
Well, if you need the money, you need the money.
Oh, of course. I forgot. What's a little summer cottage compared to the earth-shattering things you've been through?
Do you have more cream?
Yes.
What do you want more cream for?
The coffee's strong.
It's weak.
But it's too strong for me.
A few months in the army, they're experts on everything, even coffee.
Who said that?
When I was your age, I was in the business 9 years. 9 years. When I was 17, they sent me down to Brazil for 3 months on business.
I know.
I'd never even been out of New York before, and I went down there on my own, and I did my job.
Yeah, that was for Emerson, wasn't it?
No uniform, no buddies, no Uncle Sam to lean on, just myself. All alone in a strange place.
Yeah, that was the time you grew the mustache to make yourself look older, right?
Who's telling this story? 35 years in the business, he's gonna tell me about coffee.
I wasn't telling you anything about anything. All I was saying, it was for me the coffee is too strong.
It isn't strong.
What time is dinner?
Mama expects us at 12.
I suppose you'll be wearing your uniform.
Yeah, it's the only thing I have that fits.
Are you sure? Maybe you haven't grown as much as you think.
Ravioli?
And meatballs.
GI Bill, home loans, discharge bonus, unemployment insurance. You boys did pretty well for yourselves.
They did pretty well for us, too.
Oh, say, can you say?
What's your point, Pop?
The war's over.
Well, I'll buy that.
The world doesn't owe anyone a living, including veterans.
Well, I'll buy that, too.
Let the Jews support you.
Come again?
Wasn't for them, we wouldn't have gotten into it in the first place.
Oh, I thought you broke that record.
Lousy kikes.
John!
I think I changed my mind. I think I'll have some toast.
Now don't tell me you've lost your great love for the Jews.
Stop it!
It's all right.
How nice of you to let me talk in my own house. And me, not even a veteran!
Would you mind telling me what you're so mad about?
Who's mad?
Anything on the toast?
Some honey if you've got it.
Man states a few facts and right away he's mad.
How about strawberry jam?
No.
If I get a good offer, I may even sell the lake house.
Peach?
Yes.
Hurry up and finish your breakfast.
What for?
Mass starts in 20 minutes. You're not even dressed yet.
Mass?
Mass.
Pop, I haven't been to mass in over 2 years. You know that.
Lots of bad habits you boys picked up. You're gonna have to get over.
I'm not going to mass isn't a habit that I picked up. It's a decision I came to after a lot of thought.
Well, what is that for a Catholic to talk?
Pop, I haven't considered myself a Catholic for quite some time now.
Must be something wrong with my ears.
You knew this was coming. Why pretend it's such a shock?
Now there's a familiar alliance. So you've outgrown the faith.
Doesn't answer my needs.
Outgrown your old clothes and outgrown the faith.
Pop, will you listen to me?
Billions of people have believed in it since the beginning of time, but it's not good enough for you.
Well, it's not a question of not good enough.
When people ask what religion you are, what do you tell them?
Nothing.
You tell them you're nothing?
Yes.
The Clearys have been Catholic since the beginning of time. And now you, a Cleary, are going to tell people you're nothing.
Yes.
You're an atheist.
John!
When you get to the blank for religion on those college applications, put down atheist. Should go over real big in some of those Ivy League places, from what I hear.
I am not an atheist.
Then what are you?
I don't know, but I'd like a chance to find out.
You don't know what you believe in?
Do you?
Yes.
Well, tell me. Go on.
I believe in the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. I believe that God created man in his image, that Jesus died.
If your faith works for you, that's great. I wish it worked for me, but it doesn't.
You believe in God, yes or no?
I don't believe in heaven or hell or purgatory.
Yes or no?
I believe that there's something bigger than myself. What you call it or what it is, I don't know.
This is a fine how to do.
Yesterday you said he was a man. A man has a right to decide such things for himself.
Good morning, Father Riley. Good morning, Mr. Cleary. I understand your boy's home from the service. Yes, Father. Well, where is he this fine Sunday morning, Mr. Cleary? He's home, Father. Oh, is he sick, Mr. Cleary? No, Father. Well, why isn't he here in church, Mr. Cleary? Because he's an atheist, Father.
I am not an atheist!
Well, I don't care what you are, but I don't have it. I'm the boss of this house, and while you're living here, you'll do as I say. And I say you're going to mass with me this morning.
Do you know what you're doing?
You keep out of
this. Don't pay any attention.
Well?
It's all right. I'll go to mass with you. give me a minute to finish dressing.
Forget it.
What?
I said forget it. God doesn't want anyone in his house who has to be dragged there. Score another one for your side.
This has nothing to do with her.
Someday you're going to be down on all fours, and you'll be glad to see a priest then.
You'll be in Mama's for dinner.
I won't be there.
She expects us.
We all have our disappointments.
Listen, I said that I would come with you.
Oh! Now, what was that all about?
Why didn't I just go with him?
I will never understand that.
Why didn't I just go with him? Why did I have to make an issue?
It wasn't your fault.
Oh, it never is.
Well, he's in one of those moods. There's nothing anybody can do.
The Alliance, he called us.
Everybody is entitled to their own beliefs.
Well, that's what we must seem to him, an alliance. Always two against one. Always us against him. Why?
If you're finished eating, I will clear the table.
Didn't you hear me?
Evidently, your father's not the only one who's got up on the wrong side of the bed this morning.
I'm not talking about this morning.
There's no need to shout.
You and him and me and what's been going on here for 20 years, it's got to stop.
What's got to stop?
We've got to stop ganging up on him.
Is that what we've been doing?
Well, you said you never understood him.
I never will.
Well, have you ever really tried?
On.
Have you ever tried to see things from his point of view?
What things?
Well, the lake house, for instance.
Oh, the lake house?
Yeah, well, it's the pride and joy of his life, and you're always knocking it.
And you know why?
Yeah, because he bought it without consulting you.
He drove me out to this godforsaken lake, pointed to this bungalow with no heat or hot water, and said, this is where we're spending our summers from now on.
Well, the point is, would he have gotten it any other way? If he had come to you and said he wanted to buy a cottage on a lake in New Jersey, would you have said yes?
And I guess?
No. Not if it had been a palace with 50 servants.
I don't like the country.
Yeah, we would have spent every summer right here.
My idea of a vacation is to travel, see something new.
You had a chance to see Brazil.
That was different.
Well, a fellow who took that job is a millionaire now.
And still living in Brazil.
Oh, which is not to be compared with the Bronx.
Oh, so it's my fault that we're not millionaires.
Your mother would have loved Brazil. You violently objected from moving from Yorkville to the Bronx. Why?
I hate the Bronx.
Yet you insisted that your mother move up here.
They tore down her building. She had to move somewhere.
You know, except for summers at the lake, have you ever gone 2 days without seeing her?
Only because of Willis?
Ugh.
Where are you going?
I'm going to get dressed. Then I'm going to church to apologize to him for acting like a fool.
You'll be at Mama's for dinner?
Only if he'll come with me.
You disappointed Willis yesterday. You cannot do it again today.
Oh, yes, I can.
How cruel.
Cruel? Not as cruel as you're dragging me down there every day when I was a kid. And when I got older and couldn't go every day concentrating on Sunday, oh, is it too much to give your crippled cousin one day a week? And when I couldn't go there on Sunday, I felt so guilty I couldn't enjoy myself anyway. I hate Sunday. And I don't think I'm ever going to get over it, but I'm going to try.
How fortunate for the cripples of this world that everyone isn't as selfish as you.
Why do you keep calling him a cripple? It's not the worst thing wrong with Willis, it's his mind. He's like a four-year-old.
Can a four-year-old read a book?
Yes, he reads.
Oh.
After you drill him day after day for 20 years, but does he have any idea what he's reading about? If you and the rest of them over there want to throw your lives away at him, then you go right ahead. But don't try to sacrifice me to the cause. I was only trying to... Where are you going? Mother doesn't expect us until 12. Just give me a minute to finish dressing and I'll go with you. Look! This thing is like lead. All your coins in here. You're taking all your coins. What for? Please say something to me.
Thank you for the roses.
I remember sitting like this the night she went to have John.
Why would she just walk out, not telling anyone where she was going?
I was six.
Not any reason.
Dr. Goldman came in at midnight and took her to the hospital.
Doesn't make sense.
After they left, I started to cry. You did too.
It's not like her.
I asked you if you loved her. You nodded. I asked you to say the words. You hesitated. I got hysterical. Finally, to calm me down, you said, "I love her."
Maybe she's at Sophie's.
No. I called Sophie.
After 10 o'clock.
I called everybody.
She's been gone 12 hours.
They all said they'd call back if they'd seen her.
She's not by 11 o'clock, I'm pulling the police.
I wonder what difference it would have made if John had lived.
I wonder what department you call.
I remember going to see her on a Sunday afternoon. I had to wait downstairs. It's the first time I ever heard the word incubator. Incubator.
I guess you call missing persons.
After we left, we started down the concourse and we ran into a very exotic Spanish woman that she'd met on one of the trips to Brazil. She was a dancer. Very beautiful. You and she spoke a while, and then you and I went to the movies. Fred Astaire and Ginger Rogers and Flying Down the Rio.
What are you talking about?
I always thought that was a coincidence. Meeting a woman from South America, then going to see a movie about Brazil. Was it a coincidence?
What?
Hey, Rio, flying down to Rio. Got to get to Rio, because I've got to make some time.
You're drunk.
Abracadabra, cadija slattering.
By the time you picked for it.
Bunch of chorus girls. Standing on the wing of this giant plane, singing that song. Hey, Rio, flying down to Rio.
You were the last one who saw her. The police are going to want to question you.
She left the house at 10 a.m., Your Honor. Didn't say boo, but I assumed she was going to her mother's. Blue coat, blue hat. When I got there, she wasn't there. I hadn't seen her. Hadn't heard from her. So I had two helpings of ravioli and meatballs and came back here. When she didn't come home by 3 o'clock, I started to worry.
And drink.
She didn't come home by 3 o'clock, I started to worry. Tried to get in touch with my father. Called all the bars I could think of. Yeah, is Mr. Cleary there?
You know, when you see him, would you tell him to call his house? Yeah, it's just like old times.
I told you, I had dinner and went to a movie.
Is Mr. Cleary there? Shows you how long I've been gone. You don't say, is Mr. Cleary there? You say, let me speak to Mr. Cleary, as if you knew he was already there.
I was at a movie.
Did it have a happy ending?
Gilda, with Rita Hayworth and Glenn Ford.
I didn't ask you what it was.
At the Lowe's Paradise.
I didn't ask you what it was!
What's the matter with you?
Join me?
No. I think you've had enough.
First time I ever saw you refuse a drink.
I want you to stop.
And you're powerless to stop me. Which is a terrible position to be in, I should know.
At your last one.
Take it! And I leave.
Joy, joy, said Mrs. Malloy.
Louder, louder, said... What rhymes with louder?
You were drunk last night. Drunk the night... I've got it. Hello? Oh. Nothing. I said we haven't heard anything. Yes, I know how long she's been gone. Of course I'm concerned. I don't care how I sound, I'm concerned. Well, if she's not here by 11 o'clock, that's exactly what I... It's a very comforting bit of information. Her mother wanted to let me know how many muggings there's been lately.
I've got it. Earl Browder.
What?
Louder, louder, said Mrs. Earl Browder.
I'm glad you can take the whole thing so calmly.
Oh, to quote a famous authority, I don't care how I sound, I'm concerned.
10 minutes after 10.
Trouble with you is you haven't had enough experience with these matters.
Where the devil can she be?
I'm an old hand.
I've never done anything like this before in my life.
All those nights I lay awake, waiting for your key to turn in that door. Part of me praying you'd come home safe. Part of me dreading the sound of that key because I knew there'd be a fight.
I'll give her a few minutes more.
All those mornings I woke up sick. Had to miss school. Oh, the boy's delicate, everyone says. He's got a weak constitution.
Give it a half past.
From the moment I left this house, I wasn't sick once. It took me a long time to make that connection.
Where could she go? She has no money.
Wrong.
What? What? Who said wrong?
Hey, Rio. Flying down Rio.
I want to know what you meant.
She took her coins! Got to get to Rio. Guess I've got to make time.
Why didn't you mention this before?
Slipped my mind.
Over $50 in dimes and quarters. She took them all!
Yes.
You saw her take them?
Yes.
Didn't that strike you as peculiar?
Everything strikes me as peculiar.
It's something you're not telling me.
Well, we all have our little secrets.
There is something.
Yeah. Like you and your money, for example.
I want to know what it is.
Hey, for all I know, we're millionaires.
I want to know why your mother left this house. Hey,
just between us chickens, how much money do you have?
Answer me.
You put that bottle down or I'm leaving.
I want an answer.
See you at the pool hall.
I want an answer!
Hey, that is a hell of a way to treat a veteran.
I've taken all the crap from you, I'm going to.
You want an answer, I want a drink. It's a deal.
First the answer.
I forget the question.
Why did your mother leave this house?
We had an argument.
About what?
I don't remember.
Probably something to do with your drink.
Yes. She said I drank too much.
She's right.
Yes.
I never thought I'd see the day when you and her would argue.
Neither did I.
She didn't say where she was going, just took all her coins and left?
Yes.
Beats me.
Where are you going?
Grab a bite to eat.
Eat?
I didn't have any supper.
A second ago, you were so worried you couldn't even sit down.
I'm just gonna make a sandwich.
Oh, have a banquet.
What are you mad at me for? You're the one who argued with her.
Oh, Chazal's you completely. Oh, she could jump off a bridge, but your conscience is clear.
Person who's gonna do a thing like that usually doesn't bring a bunch of change along.
She thanked me for the roses! Don't you have any consideration for other people's feelings?
Consideration?
Don't you know how much it pleased her to know they came from you?
You talk to me about consideration.
How could you do it?
Do you know how forward I looked to this morning to mass and stopping off at Rafferty's afterwards with you in your uniform?
Oh, always the injured party.
You'll be the injured party in about 2 minutes.
I already am.
Real rough you've had it. Good food, good clothes, always a roof over your head.
Oh, hey ho, everybody. It's count your blessings time.
I'll tell you what rough is. Being so hungry you begged. Being thrown out into the street with your few sticks of furniture for all the neighbors to enjoy. Never sleeping with less than 2 other people to a bed. Always hiding from bill collectors. Having to drop out of school at the age of 10 because your old man was crippled for life, and it was your job to become the support of the household. You had it rough, all right.
The subject was roses.
Where I couldn't have gone with your advantages, what I couldn't have been.
I still want to know why you told her about the roses.
We were having words and it slipped out.
Words about what?
Stop pushing me, or I'll tell you.
Go on. Go on!
The humping I'm getting is not worth the humping I'm getting.
You pig.
I'm warning you.
I won too many. Lost my cathedral slattery.
Where have you been? I was going to call the police. Are you going to tell me where you've been?
You wouldn't believe me.
Of course I believe you.
You don't look well.
Looks can be deceiving. I feel terrible.
Why wouldn't I believe you?
You just wouldn't.
Tell me, see.
I went to the movies.
Go on.
That's it.
You were at the movies.
That's right.
You've been gone over 12 hours.
I stayed for several shows.
You were at the movies for 12 hours.
I knew you wouldn't believe me.
I believe you.
Thank you.
What did you see?
That means you don't believe me.
No, I guess not.
I demand to know where you were.
I went to the Hotel Astor, picked up a man, had a few drinks, a few jokes, went up to his room.
Stop it!
I was just getting to the best part.
You're making a fool out of yourself.
Is there anything I could say that you would believe?
Say, you took a bus downtown, walked around, visited a museum, had dinner, went to Radio City and came home.
I took a bus downtown, walked around, visited a museum, had dinner.
Went to Radio City and came home. I'll buy that. And if you had any sense, you'd buy it too.
I don't have any sense. I'm just some poor, ignorant slob whose wife's been missing for 12 hours and I want to know where she was.
What difference does it make?
You keep out of this.
How?
What are you going to tell your mother?
Nothing.
The poor woman's half out of her mind.
There's a joke in there somewhere.
At least call her and tell her that you're home.
She'll want an explanation, and when I tell her, she won't believe me any more than you do.
I'll believe you when you tell me the truth.
What is truth?
Oh,
sorry.
I'll tell you this. In all my life, the past 12 hours are the only real freedom I've ever known.
Did you enjoy it?
Every moment.
Then why did you come home?
I'm a coward.
Will someone please tell me what's going on here?
Well, you heard the question, folks. You, sir. The gentleman in the balcony with the beard.
You'll have to excuse me, folks. I'm about to be ill.
I don't give you enough credit. Feels that you're quite a guy. Said that we had to stop ganging up on you.
Oh, sorry.
I couldn't sleep.
Neither could I. Just came out to get a magazine.
You feel all right?
Yeah.
What time is it?
It's around 2. You all right?
Yes.
Yeah. Oops, I'll turn in.
Isn't there something you want to tell me?
Well, actually, there is, but it'll keep till
you've
morning.
Decided to leave?
Yes.
When?
This isn't a sudden decision.
When are you leaving?
In the morning. A fellow I went to high school with has a flat on 22nd Street, and his roommate's getting married, and he needs a replacement, so I figured... Hey.
penny for them.
An apple core.
What?
An apple core. I was due to start working for a law firm. I had passed all the interviews and had been notified to report for work the following Monday. On Sunday, my sister and I were walking in the park when a blonde boy who had a crush on me but was too bashful to speak demonstrated his affection by throwing an apple core at me, which struck me here. When I woke up Monday morning, I had the most beautiful black eye you ever saw. Too embarrassed to start a new job looking like that, I called in sick. And they called back to notify me that the position had been filled by someone else. The next job I found was the one that brought your father and I together. I often think of that albacore and wonder what my life would have been like if it had never been thrown.
Everybody wonders about things like that.
I was going in early to type up some dictation I'd taken the night before. Front Street was deserted. As I walked, I had the sensation of being watched. I glanced up at this office I was passing and saw this young man, your father, staring down at me. He regarded me intensely, almost angrily for a moment, and then suddenly realized that I was looking back at him and turned away. In that moment, I knew that that young man and I were not suited for each other. But at the same time, I knew that we would become involved, that it was inevitable.
Why? I mean, you did have others to choose from.
Oh, yes. All gentle and considerate men. Oh, very much like my father. Like the baker from Paterson, New Jersey, that we always used to joke about.
This fellow used to bring you a hat box full of pastries whenever he came to call.
What a sweet man. How he begged me to marry.
Well, what was it that drew you to Pop?
I think it was his energy. He had a certain wildness, not like my father at all. I was attracted, and I was afraid. I've always been a little afraid of him. But then he was clearly a young man who was going places. 24 when I met him, and making well over 100 a week. Great money in those days, and his prospects were unlimited. Money was never plentiful in our house. We weren't poor like his people, you understand, never without rent or food or tickets to the opera or nice clothes. But still, we weren't well-to-do. My father would bring home stories from the hotel about the various bigwigs who went there, what they wore and how they talked and how they acted. And we went to the opera, and we had friends who were cultured. Musical Sunday afternoons. Those were Papa's happiest moments. Yes, I liked good things. Things that the baker from Paterson and others could never give me. But your father surely would. By the way he was going, he would be a millionaire. That was his dream, you know, to be a millionaire by the time he was 40. 1929 took care of that. And he was never quite the same afterwards. But when I met him, he was cock of the walk. Good-looking, witty young Irishman. Everybody liked him. And those that didn't at least feared him, because he was a fierce fellow. Everybody wanted to go into business with him. Everybody wanted to be social with him. He was immediately at home on any ship or train. Or any bar. Strangers thought he was magnificent. And he was, as long as the situation was impersonal. At his best, in an impersonal situation. But that didn't include the home and the family.
the baker from Patterson, was all tongue-tied on the outside, but in the home, he would have been beautiful. Go to bed now.
When I left this house 3 years ago, I blamed him for everything that was wrong here. And when I came home, I blamed you. Now I suspect that no one's to blame. Not even myself. Good night.
Good night.
Want the light off?
Please. Who loves you, Nettie? You do, Papa. Why, Nettie? 'Cause I'm a nice girl, Papa.
One word from you, that's all it would take.
I'm not so sure.
Try.
No.
You want him to leave?
No.
Then say something before it's too late.
What would you like for breakfast?
Oh, who cares about breakfast?
Jimmy's having scrambled eggs.
Am I the only one who's concerned about what's going on here?
No.
But how can you just stand there?
Would you feel better if I left?
You'll cry when he's gone.
But not now.
All I want you to do is tell him how you feel.
He knows that.
You won't speak to him?
I can't.
You'll miss him the most. With me, it's different. I have my business.
I envy you.
Just ask him to stay a couple of days. Think it over.
After a couple of days, it'd be that much harder to see him leave.
Well, he might change his mind. He might not want to leave.
He has to leave sometime.
But not now. Not like this.
22nd Street is not the end of the world.
If he walks out of this house today, I don't want to see him ever again.
If you say that to him, you make it clear that you're speaking for yourself.
Who's this fellow he's moving in with?
A boy he knew in high school.
Everything he has is right here. Food, clothes, a room of his own. He has to move into some dingy cold water flat.
I think I understand his feeling.
Home 2 days and gone again. The neighbors will have a field day.
I'm going in to call him now.
Nettie, I want to see him alone.
If you're wise, you won't start a row.
I want to see him alone.
All right.
I understand you decided to leave us. What's this nonsense about you leaving us? Your mother says that you've decided to move out. Mind telling me why? I demand to know why. Would you be so good as to tell me why? Why, goddammit?
Good morning.
Morning.
Mother said you wanted to see me.
Sleep well?
Yes.
Good.
You wanted to see me?
Your mother says that you're leaving.
That's right.
It's rather sudden, isn't it?
Not really.
Mind telling me why?
I just think it's best.
For who?
Everybody.
Oh, crap. Wait, I didn't mean that. The fact is, I had no business hitting you.
That's not why I'm leaving.
If there was any way I could undo last night, I would.
It's not a question of last night.
If I could do it all over again, I'd be cut off my arm.
Pop.
I don't know what gets into me sometimes.
I'm not leaving because of anything that happened last night. I always intended to leave.
You never mentioned.
I plan to stay a couple of weeks and then go.
A couple of days isn't a couple of weeks.
Well, it's not like I'm moving to China.
But why 2 days instead of 2 weeks?
Because I know if I stay 2 weeks, I'll never leave.
If it's what I said yesterday about me being the boss and you having to do everything I say, forget it.
It's not
I was just letting off steam.
It's not that.
As far as I'm concerned, you're a man. You can come and go as you please, do as you please. And that goes for drinking, religion, anything.
Papa, you listen
Even
to me.
Girls. I know what it's like to be your age. Just give me a little advance notice. I'll make sure you have the place as long as you want.
Pop, for Christ's sake.
Oh, what sort of language is that to you? I'm sorry. Speak any way you want.
I don't know what to say to you.
What I said yesterday about the Jews, I was just trying to get a rise out of you.
I know.
When those bums from St. Matthew's jumped the iCash clothesman, I was the one who saved them.
I know.
Whole crowd of people standing around. I was the only one who did anything.
Do you think I could forget that?
Stay a week. Stay another week.
No.
Stay till Wednesday.
I can't.
Do you know how much your mother looks forward to your coming home?
Yes.
How can you do this?
Pop, we're just going around in circles here.
What happens to the summer house?
What about it?
Without you, what's the good of it?
I'll be spending time there.
Yeah, but I thought we could have a real summer together, like before the war.
Pop, you're making this a lot harder than it has to be.
Don't you think I could just sit here and say nothing like her?
Are you through?
I know what the trouble is. You know what the trouble is? You're stubborn. Like me. All us Clearys are stubborn. We would rather die than admit a mistake. Is that a fact, yes or no?
I don't know.
Well, here's one donkey who's seen the light. I've been wrong in my dealings with you, and not just last night, but all along. Those days are gone forever. I'll prove it to you. Do you know how much money I have?
I don't want to know.
$14,357.
Pop.
A little bit more in stocks. There. Now you admit, you made a mistake. Admit you don't really want to leave, and we'll forget the whole thing.
But I don't want to leave.
Oh, see?
But I'm leaving.
Then go and good riddance!
Pop, will you listen to me?
The sooner the
better. Will you listen to me? There was a dream I used to have about you and I. It was always the same. I would be told that you were dead. And I would run crying into the street, and someone would ask me, "Why are you crying?" And I would say, "My father's dead. And he never said he loved me."
I only ask you to stay for her sake.
I had that dream again last night. I was thinking about it all morning when something occurred to me that hadn't occurred to me before.
She's the one who'll miss you.
Yes, it's true that you've never said you've loved me. But it's also true that I've never said those words to you.
I don't know what you're talking about.
I love you, Pop. I love you.
Ready for breakfast?
What I said before about the money, that's strictly between us.
Yeah, okay? I understand.
Sit down. Well, your bags are packed and ready to go.
I changed my mind.
What?
I changed my mind. I think I'm going to stay for a few days.
I'm afraid that's out of the question. When you said you were leaving, I called the painters. They're coming in to do your room tomorrow. You know how hard it is to get painters. If I send them away now, it'll be months before they're free again.
And I guess I better leave as scheduled.
Yes, I think that's best. Don't you?
Yes.
I don't know why I bother bringing good coffee into this house. If it's not too hot, it's too cold. If it's not too cold, it's too strong. If it's not too strong, it's too weak.